to our conference. I want to thank the Lord for Birth and Titus II Ministries. I want to thank the Lord for Katie, the visionary, praise God, and Miss Anita, and our sister in her absence, Tara Cummings, who was not able to be with us this year. But we want to welcome you all for coming, because without you, it wouldn't be a conference.
Amen.
So we thank you. So let's give the Lord a praise. Amen. To worship and pray, so we're going to ask Eric, as I read the scripture in prayer, we're going to ask Eric and them to get prepared and come on up, wherever they want to sit, to take us into worship and praise. Praise God. Amen. The scripture reading this morning, it's going to come from Psalms 139, verses 14 to 17. I will confess and praise you, for you are fearfully and wonderful, and for the awesome wonder of my birth. Wonderful are your words, and that my inner self knows right well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being formed in secret, intricately, curiously wrought, as if embroidered with various colors in the depth of the earth, a region of darkness and mystery. Your eyes saw my unformed substance,
yes.
And in your book all the days of my life were written before forever, they took shape when as yet there was none. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word. Praise God. And let's just go before the Lord in a word of prayer. We had been in prayer earlier, but we will turn it over to Erica. Gracious Father, we just glorify you and thank you yet again for this time that you have prepared for us. And Lord, we ask that you prepare the hearts of all those who are here today. We thank you and praise you for them. And if you have your books prepared for worship, praise and worship is going to be coming from a gospel recording artist, Sister Erica Walker. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Y'all know it's in the Bible.
My hallelujah belongs to God.
Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless you.
Let's give the Lord a praise offering. We're not going to have an opportunity to read everybody's bio, but if you have a book, please read the bio of those who are that have gone before us. But today, we didn't do this yesterday, but today we will read the bios of our speakers, at least some of them, anyway. And then when we do our honorees, we will highlight them because we want you to know why we're honoring them, okay? So we're going to get started with Sister Samson. Praise God. Praise God. Erica Samson, Pastor Erica Samson, she is our first speaker today. Erica Samson is a woman who sincerely loves the Lord and serves humanity. She has a passionate desire to see women set free of past hurts and failures. She loves the Word of God and is a prophetic scribe. She has written hundreds of poems that the Heavenly Father has spoken to her spirit to encourage the body of Christ. She's a graduate of Winston-Salem State University. Erica and her husband Anton pastors the Freedom Center Church in Columbus, Ohio. They have been happily married for 24 years. They have 5 children. God bless you. Homeschool for 7 years. God bless you. In her free time, she enjoys volunteering. That takes special people. That just takes special people. God bless you. And in her free time, she enjoys volunteering, has been a hospice volunteer for nearly 5 years. Also, I want to let you know that Pastor Erica Sampson has written a poetry book. And it's called Freedom Now, and it's available. It's available for sale if anybody wants to bless her and support her. And we'll have that at the end of the conference. And at this time, without further ado, let's say God bless you, Pastor Jackson.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
It is a blessing to be here. I want to say thank you to Minister Anita, to Minister Bernie, to Minister Katie for having me. And this has been a blessing from yesterday morning to even just the worship, even that song, My Hallelujah Belongs to You, and then even to fill me up. You know, I'm going to be speaking about love and humility. And even when they were singing, when we were singing that song, you know, we were singing, if you provide the fire, that I'll provide the sacrifice. Well, the thing that he wants to us to sacrifice is all that junk.
Right.
All that stuff that is coming between us loving and being humble.
Yeah.
You know? And then we said, fill me up. Well, if we're really singing that, there's things that he's going to bring up in our hearts and in our spirit that are not right. We sing that song, you know, and I bring the fire. The fire burns stuff up. And, you know, we're speaking about the gift. And you don't want anything to be separating you. You know, and if there's a lack of love, if there's a lack of humility, see, we can continue to function. We can function. The Bible says that people are going to, in Matthew, that it says that individuals, they're going to say, Lord, Lord, but I prophesied in your name.
Mm-hmm.
I healed the sick in your name. And he's going to say, you worker of iniquity. Mm-hmm. I know you're not.
Amen.
How do you get there? How do you do all this?
Mm.
The gift. Yes. Function in the gift.
Yes. Amen.
And then he says, I know you not.
Come on,
what if the iniquity was because there was a lack of love in your heart?
Come on.
What if it was because you weren't humble? That you thought, well, I did it. You know, that person is saying, I did that. Instead of knowing that it's through the Heavenly Father and through Him birthing through you, and then that you it's Him doing it.
Amen.
It's Him doing it.
Amen.
And so He wants us to be humble.
Yes,
He wants us to be filled with love.
Yes,
so if you can turn in your Bible to Philippians chapter 2. Philippians I'm going to pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for this day that you have given to me. Lord God, I thank you for bringing us, your woman, together. Sisters for real. I bless you, Lord God, for that ministry, Father. And Lord God, I pray that we would be sisters for real. Not just in this conference, but understand that there's sisters in the grocery store, Father. That there's sisters in the post office. There's sisters on the street. And Lord God, I pray that we would be your hands and feet. And Lord God, I thank you for your living word. I thank you for what you're speaking to us yesterday and today, Father. And so, Lord God, I pray, Father, that all of us would hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. So, Lord, I thank you and I bless you. In Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen. So, I'm going to read Philippians chapter 2, verses 1 through 4. And I'm going to explain a little too. It says, if there be any consolation, and consolation means comfort, or compassion for someone who is suffering. If any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any vow, which is your inward affections, or pity, or sympathy, or any mercy, fulfill ye my joy, that ye be like-minded, having the same love, being of one accord, of one mind. Let nothing be done through strife, bitter or vigorous conflict, struggle. So the strife is bitter or vigorous conflict, or struggle for victory, or vainglory, which is excessive pride, or outspoken conceit. So that's the first three verses. And so right here, Paul is speaking to the Philippians, and we see that he is kind of begging them, like saying, you know, get together. He says four different ways, hey, if there's any consolation, if there's any comfort of love, if there's any fellowship in the Spirit. The Heavenly Father, he speaks that same thing to us. He wants us to be united in Christ Jesus. He doesn't want it to be, this is my show, that's her show, that's her show. He wants us to be able to come together in love. And so even you see there's four, he says the same, it's like-minded, same, one accord, one mind. Four different times he says the same thing. He's just saying unite, love one another. See, if we don't love sincerely, then we'll close ourselves out.
Amen.
Even last night, Minister Montgomery, he spoke about how, you need to dig up that talent and that gift. And he tapped on it. He said about some of you or us have been hurt.
Amen.
Have been disappointed. I even actually wrote down because I was thinking, it was the truth.
Yeah.
He said that it's time to dig up your gift and talent and ability. Yeah. He said, some say they have hurt me. They have wounded me. So then I hid it and discarded it. Said, but God tells you to stop.
He
wants to deliver you from your hurt.
Amen.
Because see, you can't love like he wants you to love. And even when he said it, the Lord had told me to bring this with me. What is this thing?
Love.
I brought this little book.
You've never been hurt.
Love like you've never been hurt. Love like you've never been hurt. The only way you can love like you've never been hurt is to forgive. It's to let it go, release it. Because your gifts, you want your gifts and talents, the things that God has placed within you, what he birthed you to do and be, you want it to be clean. You want it to come out purely. You don't want people to meet you. And you can prophesy. There's other gifts. And so I even thank God for Mother Smith yesterday. It's right here. Because even in it, did you notice those that were here when she ministered? She was ministering about the gift, but she said, oh, wait a minute, before we start, let's go to page 18. She skipped all these pages about love.
Amen.
That's what he is.
Amen.
And so when we see other stuff coming up out of us,
yes,
that is not love, then it's not God.
Come on.
It's not God.
Amen. Come on.
He has such an awesome life for each of us.
Yes, yes.
And he has placed something in all of you.
Amen.
We are all valuable.
Yes, Lord.
He loves us.
Yes, yes.
And there are individuals, yes, that have been hurt.
Hallelujah.
That people mistreated.
Mm-hmm.
But do not, don't allow there be residue.
Amen. All right. Come on.
Give it to the Heavenly Father.
Yes, yes.
Give it.
Yes.
Let it go.
Yes, sir.
Let it go.
Yes, sir.
So that
yes.
you can function
yes.
and be the woman that God has
yes.
made you to be. And then judgment day comes, and then there's questions about the character.
Come on.
You don't
Thank you, Lord. Yes.
It says a lot of Christians say that they are fighting the good fight of faith. Mm. But when someone comes up against them, they rise up with meanness and hate. Mm. Others express that they wrestle not against flesh and blood. Mm. But when they don't like someone, they view them as a filthy pile of mud. Mm. If you profess to be a Christian, then live and believe what you say.
Amen.
Because Christ was the perfect example.
Amen.
And has shown us the righteous way.
Yes.
He was all about amazing love and seeing people become free. Yes. He desires that same through our lifestyle so that others would want to live in victory. Are we presenting the unbeliever with an example of Jesus Christ? Or are we doing what they've done by not being a true light? If you plan to love unconditionally, then you have to be so strong. You must learn to treat others kindly, even if they do you wrong. Please remember that it is not your place to get others straight.
Amen.
Instead, ask the Father to fill you with love before it is too late. If someone treats you despicably, still walk in love and pray.
Amen.
Allow Christ to truly shine through you each and every day.
Yes.
And then Matthew 5, verse 43 through 44, it says, ye have heard that it hath been said, thou shalt love thy neighbor and hate thine enemy.
Amen.
But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you.
Amen.
That's loving like Jesus.
Amen.
That's what that is.
Yes.
And you can do it. We all can do it.
Yes.
We say Christ is in us.
Yes.
So I just encourage you all to even, as last night with Minister Montgomery, he said to let it go. Be delivered.
Yes.
Be set. Don't allow if there's stuff in you and you know it is.
Come on, man.
And you know it's hindering the gifts to function and flow.
Yes.
He's living water.
Yes.
He wants to just, like you know, you ever seen a waterfall? He just, that's how he wants to.
Yes.
You just pour.
Right?
But if we're stuck and stopped up, we are not 100%. We're not at 100%.
Amen.
So I'm going to close, but I encourage, even if we have a break, if anybody just wants, if you want prayer, if there's something that the Lord is tapping and you feel like you just need one-on-one, I have no problem with praying with anybody, okay? But love and humility.
Yes.
You all, we all can do it, and we can live in that vein.
Amen.
You just have to give it to him.
Yes. Amen.
So that the gift and the talent that he has given to us can be used for his glory.
Yes.
And not in vain.
Amen.
Angela enjoys helping others in whatever capacity she can within her capabilities. In business, she delights in helping people feel better about themselves by sharing her life's trials, tribulations, and providing cosmetology services. You know, ladies, when we look good, we feel good. Angela's mother, the late Reverend Margaret Robinson, noticed at a very young age that she had a, quote, catering spirit. Her mother would hug her so tight after saying to her, Mommy's pink little baby has such a catering spirit. How many know it is so important to give our children positive affirmations? That's what this is about. Thank you, Lord. Positive affirmations. Oh my God, not just positive affirmations, and I love that. Mommy's pink little baby has such a catering spirit. That would make me feel so good about being a caterer. I love and enjoy helping people. Thank you, Mom. I love you. Rest in peace. At this time, we're going to ask, and we're going to have Sister Katie to come and go out front, Katie, because I want him to take the picture. Sure, you can. Angela, we're going to ask you to come.
I want to.
Oh,
Lord.
Oh, Lord.
your hair done.
Glory.
This young lady did not know me or my family. We came from Pensacola. We needed our hair done. She did not know us, had never seen us in her life. She allowed us to come to her house. Now, any of you all know that Elder Hicks, you know he's big. So, I mean, she had never seen him before. But to make it short, she allowed me and my whole family to come to her house. She had never laid eyes on us before. You know, that can be a dangerous situation in this time. But we were in there in the living room, in the bathroom, in her bedroom, watching TV, all kinds of stuff. She did our hair at her house for our convenience. So if you need a good beautician, cosmetologist, stylist, whatever, if you just want to hang out with Angie, this is my baby. I've adopted her. So thank the Lord with me for her.
Angela, on behalf of Sisters for Real Titus II Ministry, we want to present you with this small token of our appreciation for who you are in Christ and think, see how God opened the door for you. So Angela Robinson, Sisters for Real Conference 2018, we are celebrating your gifts, your talents, and your abilities.
When you let God shine in your heart, you never know what a person is going through, you know, because you don't ever know what kind of love they need and the things that they're going through in their life. And I go through a lot. I go through a whole lot. And what she did for me just encouraged me to do for other people. And I had an incident the other day with a young lady. I offered to go to court with her, and she hurt me so bad and did something to me. And I lashed out to her, and I'm going home, and I'm going to let God shine through in my heart and forgive her and let it go and still be there for her. Just hold me.
Yes.
She
don't know
me. She don't know me. She don't know me. She didn't know who I was. She didn't know nothing about me. And she came to my house and brought her family to my house. She didn't know who I was. I could have been somebody that wasn't mentally stable. But, you know, it put so much love in my heart. It really did. And it encourages me to pay it forward. And it also puts me at a point where now in my community, I'm going to uphold and represent my community because I'm looked at now. And that's important. And I think it's important that we do be representatives in our community, positive representatives of our community, as we can. This is so much hurt and so much pain going on with the youth and how they rival and how they kill each other and how they hurt. So tired of that. So I really appreciate you guys for this.
It really touched
my heart. It really did. It touched my heart. So
amen.
Segue into our second speaker, who's very close to my heart. This is my pastor's wife and the co-pastor. We call her First Lady and Sister Vivian. Her name means lively, and she is about one lively and about as humble as they come. We praise God, but I love her so much. And what I want to say is that I'm going to say in the past year, Vivian and I have known each other since before over 30, longer than that, 30 plus years. I don't know if Erica was born. She was pregnant with Erica when I met her. And so, but it's been in the past 5 years or so that God has really developed our relationship. And I appreciate it because that was a prayer of mine. And we always knew each other. We were always close, but he has developed a more intimate relationship between us, and that I appreciate so dearly. So Vivian is going to come, Pastor Vivian has come today to talk about One Spirit, diversity of gifts, and different administrations, but I do want to read a portion of her bio. I'm not going to read the whole thing, okay?
Now, Vivian Walker has co-pastored Overcomers in Christ Ministry with her husband Eric for over 26 years. From an early age, she has had a heart toward God and for seeing the power of God revealed in his people. Being one of six children born of Reverend Mark and Doris Rowe, who had, was blessed to grow up in a Christian home. Vivian gave her heart to the Lord at the tender age of 17, married the love of her life, Eric, in 1980 at the tender age of 19. The two faithfully serve in ministry, Vivian teaching Sunday school while Eric taught Bible study and played the guitar. She said, used to say, play at the guitar in the early days. Don't let me talk about my pastor. In 1991, the two were called to start and pastor Overcomers in Christ Ministry, and I'm going to jump down. As minister and co-pastor of Overcomers, Vivian served God's people by teaching the Word of God with zeal and great enthusiasm. Vivian enjoys visiting and praying with families from the surrounding church area. She can also be seen with a smile on her face, displaying love and warmth to everyone she encounters. She has been his loving wife for over 37 years, loving mother of seven children and grandmother to two grandsons. Without further ado, Pastor Vivian K. Walker.
Praise God. Thank you all for inviting me.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. But I give God glory and honor. Praise God. I love you. I love each and every one of you. God is so good. And I praise God for the word that's gone forth before every session. And in every session, I just thank God for the dance, the singing, the praise. It's been wonderful. It's just blessed my box box. Okay. Praise God. All right, my topic is One Spirit, Diversity of Gifts, and Different Administrations. And my scriptures come from 1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter, starting at the 4th verse. Praise God. I'm going to run right in because I tend to be, my daughter called me a hybrid, to preach or teach. And I so, which means that means you can sometimes be a little long, so I said I better get right in there. Praise God. All right, get right in there. All right. 1 Corinthians 12 and 4. Now there are diversity of gifts, the same, but the same Spirit. And there are differences of administrations, but the same Lord. And there are diversity of operations, but it's the same God which worketh all in all. Praise the Lord, may the Lord have blessed us to the reading of the word.
Amen.
Amen. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I praise you and thank you for your unadulterated word. And I ask you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, to give me utterance today. I ask that you to give your people, give us all hearing ears to hear the Spirit sent unto the church. And we won't fail to give you all the glory and all the honor and all the praise, because to you alone it belongs. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Well, praise God, last night, not last night, yesterday morning, Sister Bessie talked about the different gifts, praise God, so I don't have to go into the different gifts, praise God, praise the Lord, but the Word of God, this Mark says, praise God, the different gifts, praise God, it says diversity of gifts, so there's distinct, different, various gifts, and everybody in here probably has some type of gift, praise God, in the body type, for the perfecting of the saints, for the edifying of the body, praise God, to become the full, praise God, for folks. Okay. Yeah, I get a little bad when I'm trying to get something. Yeah, thank God. She's right here. Calm down.
You got time.
Praise God. So there's distinct and various gifts in the body. Praise God. But Romans 4:6 says there's different, praise God, differing according to the grace of God that's been given to us, but it's the same Spirit. This scripture says that it's the same Spirit.
Yeah.
But if there's only one Spirit, then the same Spirit is given each and every one of these gifts.
Amen.
That has inspired each and every one of us. Amen. That has activated each and every one of these gifts. There might be a bunch of gifts, but there's only one Spirit.
Amen.
Praise
Amen.
God.
Amen.
And do you all know
yeah.
that same Spirit is the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead?
Yes. Amen.
There's that kind of mighty power dwelling in you.
Yes.
He said the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead.
Yes.
Oh, we're excited about that. Okay. was named on purpose.
Yes, God.
Because I did a little touch.
Yes, God.
Praise God. Okay. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And there are differences of administrations and the same Lord. Praise God. So there's different ministries. Praise God. There's different aids and services and different things that different ones does in the church. And I'm telling you, God has just blessed us as overcomers.
Yes.
Working people. We may be few in numbers, but you can see everybody working.
Yes.
Amen.
I mean, how can all these different workings, praise God. But there's one Lord that we all serve.
Amen. Amen. Yes, God.
You're not serving the pastor.
Amen.
You're not serving Anita.
Amen.
You're not serving
Kate.
There's only one Lord, one master.
Amen.
Only one master. And
Amen.
We all serve that same Lord, that
Amen.
One master.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, we all got one Lord and one master. Who should we be hearing?
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
We should be hearing and obeying.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
We are not our own. We've been bought with a price.
Amen.
A precious price of the blood of Jesus. Such a precious price. Such a precious price that a God would come and die for me. And there are diversities of operations, but it's the same God which works in all.
Amen.
In all.
Yes.
All the things that we see get done is one God. It's His purpose.
Yes.
It's His will. It's His plan that's being worked out.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if we get in ourselves and we think that the gift that He's given us is about me,
yes,
it's one body.
Yes.
And Christ is the head. The master is the head of the body.
Yes.
So we should be getting our direction. My body gets its direction from its brain.
Yes, God. Amen.
My feet don't tell my hands to clap.
Uh-uh.
It comes from the head.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Well, praise God.
Amen.
1 Corinthians 7:17 says, and I'm just reading the first part of the scripture, it says, but as God has dispersed to every man, as the Lord has called everyone, let him walk. I was thinking about this morning, let me take these glasses off because I can't see you with them on to just read it, praise God. I was thinking about if I gave my daughter my debit card to go to the store to get some food because I've got a company to serve. And I sent her to the store and I said, gave her my password to use to go to the store and get what I wanted. And I gave a list of what I wanted. I give her that and I put my trust in you that you're going to use my card, like I said. But if she went out there and she said, oh my goodness, look at that dad's wrist.
I got the password.
She going to notice it's right. Then she said, now what did she say I was supposed to get? What was that list? I had that list. And I forgot what I was supposed to get. Oh my goodness. And then she said, and then she started getting things. And then she come home. And she come home with a lot of things. And I said, I don't ever tell you to get all that stuff. What's all that? Oh, I went to the store and bought me a dress and I went and bought, you know, I had to go, I, you know, on my way. And I did this, that, and the other. But where is my main ingredient? And you know we got company now. I've got to serve these people, and this, and you got half of ingredients for my things that I need to make. I need to make a cake. Where's the cake flour? So, now, my whole thing is marred. My whole day is marred. The whole thing messed up because she didn't follow my instructions. And I like what you were teaching about love. The word God says, it's the bond of perfection.
Yeah, amen.
God.
Yeah.
It's the thing that ties it together, praise God.
Amen.
So, you know, He gives us all these different gifts, and He says, it works by love.
Amen.
So we don't have love, it don't work.
It don't work.
And how do we know, recognize love? The word of God says, if you love me, you keep my commandments. You're obedient to what I say.
Amen.
You do what I say.
Yeah.
If she loved me, she wouldn't have went to the store and bought the dress. If she loved me, she'd have took that order and went and got exactly what I said.
Yeah.
And used my security code for what I said, not what she wanted to. And it's the same thing with our gifts. If we get ready to speak to somebody and say, oh, you know what, I can't believe the Lord is telling me to give her that. I can't believe the Lord is telling me to speak to them and tell them, give them this word. And she looked at me like this. And last week I overheard her talking about me. If we take the gifts that God has given us and do what we want to do, we're marring the gifts. And I thought, we talked so much individually about our gifts yesterday. And I said, I want to look at a little bit corporately about our gifts, about the effect of what happens when we corporately obey and disobey. And I praise God, last Sunday, the word of the Lord came, one of the handmaidens of the Lord gave us a word, and she forgot to bring the copy of it, so she emailed me a copy of it. So in the word of the Lord that had come, there was something in there, and just like Sister Benson said yesterday, you look it in the word, find it in the word, and I found it in the word.
Amen.
And I said, I wonder if she knew that was in the word. So yesterday I said, did you know that was the word? She said, you know what, when it came, I was like, Lord, how does that work? I don't understand. I said, you didn't know it, but it was in the word. And she didn't know it, but it was in the word. I said, I knew it was the Lord, because I usually go and hunt. I don't just take words for you better try. You better find out if that's really the Lord saying.
Yeah.
So I took that word and I looked it up, and one of the things it said in there about a hearing and obey. And he was talking about how his people, you know, when they have things going on in their life, instead of going to him first, he said, they try to figure out who all these things are. Now I'm using my life right now. Praise God. Before they come to him, and then they come to him last. But if we come to him first, we're supposed to see first kingdom of God. All right, so he said, hear and obey. What things would happen if we heard and obey? It's the key. If we heard and obey, he said, hearing and obeying is the thing that girds us together. You know what it means to gird? Remember the prophet, the priest in the Bible, how he said, gird them with a curious girdle? It's the thing that ties them together, that binds them together, that keeps them together. If we hear and obey, we bring the whole thing together. We hold the whole thing together. All right? Everything working together for the good. Working his perfect will in his perfect way. When it's girded all together. Not the opposite, to show you that, so you can get a picture of it in your mind. It's the thing I saw the other day, a man in a grocery store, and he had groceries in his arm and holding a child, but unfortunately he was a very large man, and he had pants on without a belt, and his pants was coming off of his loins. And he looked like he was crazy. I said, if he would just gird up his loins. Walk and he wouldn't be looking like a zombie.
Yes.
But you know what? The word of God, I want you to go to Jeremiah. Then he tells him later on, go back, find the girdle, pull it again. And when he dug the girdle up, the girdle was all marred. Can y'all imagine how a girdle would be if you had holes and it was all flimsy and ragged and worn because it had been buried? It was destroyed, right, just like a body would do in the earth. It became completely marred,
mm-hmm,
and it was good for nothing.
Right.
So if we don't hear and obey, we become good for nothing.
Oh, my God.
So that's where it was.
Yes.
So he said, thus says the Lord, after this manner will I mar the pride of Judah. Now, this is talking about, let's say, this is not us. Say, this is not us.
This is not us.
This is not us.
This is not us.
All right. Thus says the Lord, after this manner will I mar the pride of Judah and the great pride of Jerusalem. So when we get in pride and we do what we want to, instead of hearing and obeying, we're in pride and we are in error. All right? And it's all marred. Everything's red. This evil people which refuse to hear my word, which walk in the imagination of their heart.
Yes.
They did all that in a bag of chips. All right? In the imagination of their heart, and walk after other gods. They put men before themselves. They're looking at men instead of looking at me. They're looking at, how they look. All these different things instead of hearing God. To serve them and to worship them shall even be as this girdle, which is good for
nothing.
For as the girdle cleaveth to the loins of a man, so have I caused to cleave to me the whole house of Israel and the whole house of Judah, which is the Lord, that they might be unto me for a people and for a name and for a praise and for a glory.
Yes.
But they would not hear. We're supposed to be his people.
Yes.
For his name and renown,
uh-huh,
for his praise,
yes,
and for his glory.